And we're rolling. Focus. Hi. It's Tuesday evening. It's the 10th of September. Daylight is still with us, just for about another 45 minutes, an hour's time. I don't know why I'm angling the camera like this, because I'm trying to hide the fact that this is there. This is Sudbury Town Tube Station, because I would have put it in the thumbnail, and I probably would have put a very, you know, obvious title to the video saying my favourite tube station. But yes, finally, something I've wanted to do for years, and I've been chatting to the press office to get permission to come down and bring a guest with me to just walk around and have a look at the wonder that is my favourite tube station, Sudbury Town. Gonna come inside. It does feel like I should introduce my special guest straight away, who is like a bad penny. I always made that joke. It's a good, like a good penny.
Yeah.
Like a Luke penny.
A Luke penny. I don't know what
that is. Are you taking photos?
Yes.
So Mr. Tube Luke Mapper is here. Luke Mapper.
Tube Mapper is easy.
Let's call you Luke Mapper.
Luke Mapper is far too mapping all the Lukes around London. No, I don't think that's too difficult.
So I'm doing a little bit of video. You're going to take some glorious photos.
Yes.
That'd be lovely.
Yes, right. A collaboration as such.
A collab. The first most obvious thing that you must note about Sudbury Town is the slightly different font on the roundels.
I'm going to blatantly cheat and just read off Wikipedia.
You all know the classic Johnston stroke New Johnston, now Johnston 100 font. Well, this is not that. This is one. This is the original, the main reason why Sudbury Town caught my attention and then made me realise of all the little beautiful architectural features which just make it a delight, is that the font is slightly different. This was in Secrets of the Piccadilly Line video as well, but it's just worth mentioning again here. It says some of the original station signage, and this is why, because I couldn't remember this, uses the Johnston Delph Smith typeface, which is a wedge serif variation of the standard London Underground Johnston typeface. It's got the little bits on the edge, which are really, really nice. Onto the westbound platform, eastbound, London bound. Even the sign for toilets is in that font, as are the signs for ladies and gents as well. And I really want to go, but I don't have 20p on me. Have you got 20p on you?
Right, not.
Pressman hasn't got 20p on him. Okay, more reasons to love Sudbury Town. Just this waiting, it's not really a waiting room, it's a waiting area. It's slightly echoey. It's curved at this end. There's these beautiful wooden benches. Where the newsagent's kiosk is, which is only open in the morning, there's a shutter this side as well. So even if you're already gate-lined side, you could still like buy your newspaper, not just from the kiosk outside the gate line. And there's the gorgeous old passimet as well, which we'll look at in a second. This is what they call pronunciation, passimeter. This wooden area here where the ticket collecting person would stand. All tickets to be shown at the barrier, please, or book here. You could buy your tickets as well, and you'd pass through on either side, obviously replaced with a modern day ticket office. But this might not have been originally here. This was probably here when it was rebuilt, this station, in the 1930s, which we'll get to in a second. But now we're on the booking hall side, on the eastbound side of the station, and we just need to look up around at this incredible space. That is fantastic. Just having to dodge the buses that terminate here outside Sudbury Town, well connected for buses. I'm going to get run over. I just wanted to come out whilst it's still light and again, get the building in the background and point out that originally Sudbury Town was part of the District Railway, what we know as the District Line. Of course, it went up to Rayner's Lane. And this wasn't the original station building. This station building, by Station Crescent, smart naming there, London Borough of Brent, came along. It's a classic Charles Holden, and when they brought the Piccadilly line up to Rayner's Lane and then through all the way down to Uxbridge, he then designed a lot of stations along this bit not Park Royal, and redid Sudbury Town in his classic style. And it just amazes me how, like, a simple block, a brick and glass structure, can just look so magnificent. But it does just look magnificent. I love it. There's even a Charles Holden-esque sort of concrete archway here, which leads to this passageway, oh, car park by the way, and then that leads up to the footbridge up here. Even the footbridge is magnificent, with the sign for the City and West End, and the one here for Harrow and Uxbridge trains. The signs are gorgeous. And look at the lamps. The lamps from now, come on, the lamps from the footbridge are gorgeous. It's all gorgeous. What's not to love about Sudbury Town? So on the Rayners Lane, Uxbridge bound side, there's this. It has a waiting area with its own nice. I don't think I've ever caught a train from Sudbury Town to Uxbridge. I've always gone that way. So it makes a change to sit here. Again, it's slightly echoey. It's just nice to reflect. It's so nice now that the light's fading and the lights have come on. It's just, I think, out of Charles Holden's, and you should, I'll put a link to who the heck Charles Holden is in case you don't know. I think he designed 49. Correct me if I'm wrong, and I'm sure you will, 49 stations for the Underground. And yeah, it's the best Holden out of all of them, and my favourite tube station. Go on, it's good, right?
Yeah.
Is it good?
It's good.
What's your favourite bit?
My favourite bit is actually, well, it'll be quite random to most people. At the back of the roundel, if you come around here, there's normally roundels at the back of them don't have any detail. But at the back of this one, you can see just a simple line. And I know it sounds really silly, but it actually makes for a nice photo. I've got a good photo up the back there, and Geoff might actually make it pop up now.
I wanted the silhouette. Has it worked? I've got the silhouette. We're at that time where it's dusk and there's lights, uplighters, in the windows where a little bit of like twilight dusk is still seeping through, but you just end up in the echoey, amazingly cool lit at dusk ticket office. It's really nice. Have I got it across to you yet? It's really nice. Come and visit. Oh, there we go. It's found my light. Come and visit Sudbury Town.
I just read.
Thanks, Luke. It's great.
I'm going home. Trains are coming. Are you going to come with me, Mr. Luke Mapper?
It's Tube Mapper.
Tube Mapper.
Tube Mapper. Everybody follow Luke.
Tube Mapper on Instagram. Yeah, that'll do.
And follow me, which you're doing already. Should we get the train home?
Yeah, time to go.
Go
see
on.
You guys.
God, admit it. It's a good. It's a nice station, right?
It is a nice station.
You said it's in your top 10. You think?
In the top, from the frontage alone, it's definitely one of the top 5 frontage.
What's your number one station then? If mine's up to 10,
we're gonna miss the train. Miss train.
Put him on the spot. Gotta go.
Sudbury Town. This is a Piccadilly line service to Cockfosters.